Hey, hello guys. Today I'm going to teach you how to make gradient waves like the one that you're going to see in your screen right now. So without any more delay, let's just start designing. We're going to start by opening Adobe Illustrator, and I already have a file here ready for you guys. It's going to be 1920 by 1080 with some colors that we can use right now as a reference. I'm just going to start by using the curvative pen tool, and we're going to start just creating some sort of a shape like this. There we go. And then just try to keep the curve. I think that will look good. And then we double click it here, double click it here, double click it here. Oh, sorry. And then we click it here. Boom. Here we have our wave, if we can call it like that right now. The next step will be to color this. One of the methods that I like to use to color this in particular, we're gonna go to the mesh tool, we're gonna select the mesh tool, or you can just press U in your keyboard. And we're gonna click first right in this side, and we're gonna select this first color, and we're gonna click like a make it purple right there. And I'm gonna just press A and try to select the purple again, just to make this side purple. That's the main goal at the beginning. So let's do, there we go. We have this purple right here. And then we press A again. I'm gonna take these two nodes and then purple again. And then this last node, purple again. Okay, so one thing I noticed is that I want to make these two notes a little darker. So I'm just going to take this purple. I'm going to make it a little, you know, darker going this way. That's perfect. And then I'm going to go press U again, and I'm going to click this part right here, maybe here at the top. And instead of doing it that color, I'm going to select this mint color that looks really, really nice. And I'm going to press A, and I'm going to take this mint color over again here. And I'm going to press the same process here. I'm going to select this mint color and here too. Okay, this is looking good. One thing I would like to do is take in this mint color that I have right here and make it a little lighter. I think it's gonna look better if you just move it a bit that way. Lighter, and then here the same thing. You just move it to a lighter color. Okay, and this one, I would like to use the same color, but I'm gonna make it a little lighter too, just to create some sort of transition right there, okay? We're gonna take this shape, and we're gonna duplicate this. So I'm gonna press Command F, and I'm gonna click Transform. I'm gonna click Reflect, okay? And I'm gonna try to take this new one that I have right here. I'm gonna stretch it like this, and a little vertical too. I'm just trying to create some waves. I think that looks really good. And the modification that I would like to do here is to change, let me take this away from here, is to change that mint color that I have right here for the orange. I think would look better just in contrast with this purple right here. So I'm gonna take this two colors, this one's right here, and I'm gonna select the orange, but I'm gonna make it lighter, like almost trying to fade. And then this one, we're gonna make it the same one, but darker. We're gonna select here. I make it a little, you know, not that dull. We're gonna make it, I think we should, the mistake here is that I need to go here and then make it more red. That's perfect. And here we have our you know, waves of gradients. We're gonna go now to Photoshop, and we're gonna create a new file, and this is gonna be the same. It's gonna be 1920 by 1080. And here we're gonna write gradient waves. Okay, we have our file 1920 by 1080. One thing that I would like to change is the, first of all, is the background. We're gonna click here, and we're gonna select create a solid, okay? Solid color right here. And we're gonna select here F1, 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 or maybe something darker, E3, E3, E3. It's a little darker. I'm gonna press okay. We're gonna go back to Illustrator, and we're gonna select the first wave that we created. We're gonna go back to Photoshop, and we're gonna paste it right there. Smart object, boom, we put it right there. This is looking good. We stretch it, that looks nice. And we're gonna select the other one that we have right here, Illustrator. Second one, the one that goes in the back. Go to Photoshop, we paste it as a smart object, of course, and we put it right there in the back. Okay, looking good. The next step will be to take this first design that we have right here, the first smart object that we created in Illustrator, and we're gonna select the filter, and we're gonna go to, and we're gonna go with a Gaussian blur. It's gonna be, this one is gonna be really soft. Maybe like, I would say like a 3 instead of a 3.7, just like a 3, and that'll be fine. And we're gonna make it a smart object again, just to be able to put another filter on top of it. Okay, selecting the first layer, we're gonna go to filter, we're gonna go to blur, and we're gonna select motion blur. And then here, we're gonna select a distance of maybe 100, I think 160, 50, 47, that will be fine, 147. We're gonna press okay. You see this white box that it shows right here in the smart filter? That's actually a mask, and that's where we can control where do we want the actual effect to take place. this effect that we're applying right now. One of the things that we could do in this situation is simply selecting the brush, okay? We're gonna select the soft one, the soft round, and we're gonna increase the size to maybe like 400, let's do 500, okay? And then we're gonna select this one, and we're gonna, using the black color in front, okay, I'm gonna press X, so to switch them, and you're gonna start, I'm gonna make it a little bigger though, maybe like, I'm pressing right now Control and Option, or Command and Option, just to stretch it while pressing the mouse, and maybe 700 will be fine. And I'm gonna start just dabbing, just to not apply that effect in some parts of the gradient. I'm gonna press X just to softly apply it in some parts of it, just to retouch it a little bit. And I'm gonna do the same thing with the other one. We're gonna go to the filter, we're gonna go to blur, and we're gonna create a Gaussian blur. We're gonna press okay, and we're gonna make it again a smart object. We're gonna go again to filter, we're gonna again to blur, we're gonna select the motion blur, okay? This one is gonna be the same, 147, we press okay. And one thing I would like to do with this layer is press Command T and just stretch it up a little bit, and I stretch it to the side a little bit. Something like that will look really good. And you see how we have these layers that we have extrapolated like that. One thing that I would want to try in this one is the same thing. Take selecting the mask that is in the smart filter, and we're going to just reduce the amount of blur in this area right here, just to make it look a little bit nice. Once we reduce the amount of blur in that area, one thing we can try to do is to select all of it and then group it and then convert it to smart object again. And we're going to go to the filter. We're going to select filter gallery. And here we're gonna go to, I think it's in texture, we're gonna select grain, and we're gonna reduce the intensity of this by a little bit, just to make it look nice. Okay, maybe like this looks good. Instead of let's do it like soft, like a soft grain right there, and we increase it a little bit, and I think this looks really, really nice like this. And let's press okay, and here we have our nice gradient. If you want to, you can add text to this. One thing that I would try to do is just to write, let's write gradients on top of it like we always do. Let's see, gradient, gradient waves. Okay, let's take this, select this, let's make it bigger. Let's change the font of this a little bit. Let's change it to something like Vultura, one of my favorite fonts. Vultura regular, and then oh, I have an idea. What if we take this and then we write waves in a different font? Let's press Command X in here. Let's just take the gradients one and Command D and Command T here, just to make it bigger. Oh, this looks good. We write gradients like there, like we always do. We press Command A and then we try to align it by selecting the move tool. We just align it there and we align it there just to have it really well centered. And then we press Command T again and we write waves, but in another font, like SAA series. And then let me try to change this to uppercase there. Instead of E dot, let's do F dot. Let me try to have it right here. F dot, that's better. Okay, let me take this, put it right here in this edge right now. Gradient waves, and then we just double click here. Oh, this looks really good. We press Option. I'm just pressing Option just to separate a little bit the typography to make it look a little better. And here we have our awesome gradients. If you feel like you learned something new, just give it a like. That'll help me a lot. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video.